When comb is rubbed with hair, some electrons transfer from hair to comb. Lightning is actually a gigantic electrical discharge between two charged clouds or between a cloud and earth. Static charges exist in this nature in different places. Is it possible to collect and store these charges? What happens when stationary charges start accumulating in a region? Let us learn in this video. In the year 1929, American physicist Robert J. Van de Graaff gave a solution by designing a machine which collects static charges and produces a large amount of electrostatic potential difference up to 10 power 7 volts. This Van de Graaff generator works on two principles, electrostatic induction and action of points. Electrostatic induction is a process of generating static electricity in a material without touching it. The electric charges on the surface of a charged object do not necessarily spread out evenly. They accumulate more at the sharper areas than at flatter areas. The leakage of electric charges from the sharp points of the charged conductor is known as action of points. Now let us see the construction of Van de Graaff generator. A large hollow spherical conductor A is fixed on the insulating stand. A pulley B is mounted at the center of the hollow sphere and another pulley C is fixed at the bottom. A belt made up of insulating materials like silk or rubber runs over both pulleys. The pulley C is driven continuously by the electric motor. Two comb-shaped metallic conductors D and E are fixed near the pulleys. The lower comb D is maintained at a positive potential of 10 power 4 volt by a power supply. The upper comb is connected to the inner side of a hollow metallic sphere. Working of a Van de Graaff generator. There is high electric field near the comb D, so air between the belt and comb D gets ionized due to the action of points. The positive charges are pushed towards the belt and the negative charges are attracted towards the comb D. The positive charges are stuck to the belt and they move up. When the positive charges are reached to the comb E, because of the electrostatic induction, comb E acquires negative charge and sphere acquires positive charge. The acquired positive charge are distributed on the outer surface of the hollow sphere. At the same time, the negative charges produced due to the corona discharge nullify the positive charges in the belt before it passes over the pulley. When the belt descends, it has almost no net charge. At the bottom, it again gains large positive charge. The belt goes up and delivers the positive charge to the outer surface of the sphere. This process continues until the outer surface produces the potential difference of the order 10 power 7 volt, which is the limiting value. We cannot store charges beyond this limit since the extra charges start leaking to the surroundings due to the ionization of air. The leakage of charges can be reduced by enclosing the machine in a gas-filled steel chamber at very high pressure. The high voltage produced in Van de Graaff generator is used to accelerate positive ions for the nuclear disintegration and other applications.